Hello everyone, today we are going to see the efficiency of spiral gears. Myself, Mr. Y.Y. Kamble, Assistant Professor, Mech Engineering Department, SIDCOE, ETRA. So today we are going to see the efficiency of spiral gears. In previous video, we seen that what is meant by helical gear and the spiral gears. In detail, we seen the spiral gears and helical gears. In last lecture, we also seen that the center distance between the spiral gears, okay, we have seen the derivations. Now today we are going to derive the equation to find out the efficiency of spiral gear. So this is what a figure. In that figure, this gear one will be here, okay, this is what a gear two, okay. In spiral gear, these are the non-parallel and non-intersecting gears. This is nothing but what a spiral gear, okay. This one will be the gear one and this two will be the gear two, okay. Now see here, this F1 is nothing but what, this force acting on this gear one, okay. This is what a driver gear and this gear two will be the driven, okay. So this is what a force acting on this gear one, that is what F1. Again, simultaneously what happens to balance this force F1, this F2 force will be here, this F2 force will be here. This will be act on this gear 2. Okay, now see here, this FA1, okay, I just zoom the figure, okay. This FA1, this is nothing but what axial thrust force acting on this gear 1, okay. Similarly, this FA2, this force will be there, this is nothing but what FA2, A for axial, this axial thrust force will be there, this axial force thrust force will be acting on these two indicators, what this is will be acting on the gear 2, okay. So the gear 1 will be the driver and gear 2 will be the driven, okay. Now this is what a common normal, this common normal passing through this point O. Similarly, see here, this R is what normal reaction, okay. Now next is what, this triangle will be there, OST, this O starts here, this S and here T. This OST triangle will be here, again this OPQ triangle will be there, okay. Now similarly see here, this RN will be the normal reaction, okay. Now this alpha 1, this is angle made with this gear 1, okay. This alpha 1, phi angle will be there, here phi angle will be here and alpha 2 angle will be there. This alpha 2 will be here, alpha 1 will be here, okay. So see here, we will see the terminologies, okay, or terms that is we are going to use in this derivation, okay. The pair of spiral gears 1 and 2 mesh as shown in figure, okay. This is what a meshing, this is shown in figure. Let the gear 1 will be the driver and gear 2 will be the driven. Here see here, gear 1 will be the driver and gear 2 will be the driven. The forces acting on each pair of the teeth is in contact are shown in figure. That means the each pair are in a contact as shown in figure. The forces are assumed to act at the center of width of each teeth and in the plane tangential to the pitch cylinders, okay. The forces are, that means these forces, that is F1 will be there, F2 will be there, FA1 will be there and FA2 will be there. Again R, that is an RN, these all the forces act on the center of width of the each teeth. That is what, these forces acting on the center of the width of the each teeth and the plane tangential to the pitch cylinders, okay. So these are the tangential to the pitch cylinders, okay. Now let's see here, F1, that is what force applied tangentially on the driver. We already seen in the figure, that is F1 is equal to what force, that is tangentially, that is force applied tangentially on the driver. Again similarly F2 is what balance force will be there, this will be the balance, the F1, that is nothing but what restoring force or resisting force, we can say this is what restoring force or resisting force acting tangentially on the driven, okay. Now see FA1, this FA1 is what axial or end thrust on the driver, okay. Now similarly see here FA2, that is what axial or end thrust on the driven. FA1 and FA2, we already seen axial thrust, that is what driver and driven, ओके नाउ आर्यन, आर्यन इज वॉट? नॉर्मल रिएक्शन एट द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. फाइव, दैट इज वॉट एंगल ऑफ फ्रिक्शन, फाइव विल बी देयर. ओके नेक्स्ट आर, आर इज वॉट रिजल्टल रिएक्शन एट द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. एंड सी हियर, थीटा इज इक्वल टू वॉट शाफ्ट एंगल, दिस इज नथिंग बट वॉट अल्फा वन प्लस अल्फा टू. सो दिस थीटा इज वॉट शाफ्ट एंगल एंड दिस इज नथिंग बट वॉट एडिशन ऑफ अल्फा वन एंड अल्फा टू. अल्फा वन दैट इज वॉट एंगल मेड विद ड्राइवर एंड अल्फा टू दैट इज वॉट एंगल मेड विद ड्रिवर. और सिंपली वी कैन से दिस इज एंगल मेड विद द गियर वन अल्फा वन एंड अल्फा टू इज वॉट एंगल मेड विद द गियर टू. बोथ आर द सेम हैंड, दैट मीन्स द गियर्स बोथ आर इन अ सेम हैंड. ओके फ्रॉम ट्राइंगल ओ पी क्यू. ओके नाउ सी हियर ओ पी क्यू, वी आर गोइंग टू सी ट्राइंगल ओ पी क्यू. सी हियर आई विल सी द जस्ट फ्रॉम ट्राइंगल ओ पी क्यू. सी हियर ओ पी क्यू एफ वन इज इक्वल टू वॉट आर इन टू कॉस ऑफ अल्फा वन माइनस थीटा. सो सी हियर फ्रॉम ट्राइंगल दिस ट्राइंगल वी आर गोइंग टू टर्म दिस ओ पी क्यू एफ वन इज इक्वल टू आर इन टू कॉस ऑफ अल्फा वन माइनस थीटा. सो सी हियर कॉस ऑफ अल्फा वन माइनस थीटा इज इक्वल टू वॉट, कॉस इज नथिंग बट वॉट एडजेसेंट साइड डिवाइड बाय हाइपोटेनस. ओके सो सी हियर हाइपोटेनस इज नथिंग बट वॉट आर विल बी देयर. ओके एंड दिस एडजेसेंट साइड विल बी एफ वन. फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन वी गॉट हियर एफ वन इज इक्वल टू आर इन टू कॉस ऑफ अल्फा वन माइनस फाइव. ओके नाउ सी हियर वर्क इनपुट टू द ड्राइवर. सो वर्क इनपुट टू द ड्राइवर दिस इज गिवन एज वॉट एफ इन टू वी. वी नो दैट वर्क इनपुट टू द ड्राइवर दिस वर्क इनपुट डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू वॉट एफ इन टू वी. ओके सो हियर एफ एफ इज नथिंग बट वॉट एफ वन विल बी हियर, वी ऑलरेडी फाइंड आउट हियर. ओके नाउ वी, वी इज नथिंग बट वॉट वी इज इक्वल टू वॉट पाई इन टू डी वन इन टू एन वन. ओके सो दिस इज वॉट द सपोज वी इज इक्वल टू वॉट पाई इन टू डी वन इन टू एन वन और सिंपली इट इज हियर स्मॉल डी वन विल बी देयर. ओके सो पुट हियर एफ वन इंटू पा इंटू डी वन इंटू एन वन, देर फॉर पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ वन. वेर इज वैल्यू ऑफ एफ वन? हियर वैल्यू ऑफ एफ वन विल बी देयर, पुट द वैल्यू हियर. ओके सो वॉट वी गॉट हियर दिस वर्क इनपुट टू द ड्राइवर इज इक्वल टू आर इंटू कॉस ऑफ अल्फा वन माइनस माइनस फाइव इंटू दिस पा इंटू डी वन इंटू एन वन. ओके सो फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन वी गॉट हियर द वर्क इनपुट टू द ड्राइवर. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू नेक्स्ट सी फ्रॉम ट्राइंगल ओ एस टी. नाउ फ्रॉम ट्राइंगल ओ एस टी एफ टू इज इक्वल टू दिस एफ टू दैट इज वॉट फोर्स. सो सी हियर ट्राइंगल डायग्राम विल बी लाइक दैट. ओके सो दिस इज वॉट डायग्राम. ओके एफ वन विल बी हियर. ओके एफ टू विल बी हियर. ओके दिस पॉइंट ओ विल बी देयर ओ एस टी. ओ एस टी ट्राइंगल विल बी लाइक दैट. ओके फ्रॉम दिस ट्राइंगल ओ एस टी. ओके सो एफ टू इज इक्वल टू वॉट आर इन टू कॉस ऑफ अल्फा टू प्लस फाइव. ओके सो वर्क आउटपुट टू द ड्रिवन और वर्क आउटपुट ऑफ द ड्रिवन दैट मीन्स वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई द वर्क टू द वॉस ड्राइवर. ड्राइवर दैट मीन्स वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई फोर्स टू द ड्राइवर. दिस ड्राइवर विल मूव द सेकेंड व्हील, दिस विल बी द ड्रिवन. ओके दैट मीन्स द वर्क विल बी आउट, वर्क आउट विल बी एट द एंड ऑफ द ड्रिवन गियर. ओके सो वर्क आउटपुट ऑफ द ड्रिवन दिस इज इक्वल टू वॉट F, work output is equal to F is F into V. This is what a work output. Okay. So F into V, V2 will be there. Okay. And here F2 will be there. So F2 into V2. V2 instead of V2, we can write here pi into D2 into N2. So we have the value of F2 put here. Value of F2 will be here. Okay. So put the value of F2 into this equation. So what we got here, R into cos of अल्फा टू प्लस फाइव इंटू पाई इंटू डी टू इंटू एन टू. ओके दिस इज वॉट द इक्वेशन. ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट सी हियर इफिशियंसी ऑफ स्पायरल गियर. सो वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द इफिशियंसी ऑफ स्पायरल गियर एंड दिस इफिशियंसी इज गिवन एज वर्क आउटपुट डिवाइड बाय वर्क इनपुट. सो इफ रेशो ऑफ दिस इफिशियंसी इज गिवन एज इट इज द रेशो ऑफ वर्क आउटपुट डिवाइड बाय वर्क इनपुट. सो वी हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ वर्क आउटपुट हियर. सी हियर आई विल सी जस्ट सी हियर we have the value of here work input will be there and work output will be there. Put the value in next equation, that is what equation will be here. Okay, put the value of work output here. put the value of work output here, work input will be there. Okay, so what is the value of work output? That is what R into cos of alpha 2 plus phi into pi into d2 into n2 divided by again work input, that is R into cos of alpha 1 minus phi into pi into d1 into n1. Okay, this is about the value of work output divided by work input. Now next is what? Here what is common? Here R is common. This R, R get cancelled here. Again pi will be common. This pi and pi, this pi, pi will get cancelled here. Okay, so what terms remain? This, that is what? Here cos alpha 2 plus phi will be there. Okay, again d2 and n2 will be here. Okay, next divided by R get, R will be cancelled here and pi will be cancelled here. So what remains? Cos of alpha 1. This cos of alpha 1 minus phi into d1 into n1. So these terms remains here. Okay, okay, now next is what? This is what we can write here. This is what equation number 1. Okay, so see here, this is what equation number 1. Now next is what we have discussed, that the piece circle diameter of gear 1. So piece circle diameter of gear 1, this is given as, we have the formula, that is what piece circle diameter d1 is equal to what? PC1 into T1 divided by pi. In earlier derivation, that is what a central distance of spiral gear, in that one we seen that. Okay, so PC1, this P circle, circular pitch equal to PC1 is equal to what? D1 into pi divided by T1. Okay, from this equation we got here D1 is equal to what? PC1 into T1 divided by pi. So we know that the PC1, this PC1, again see here, this PC1 is nothing but what? PN divided by cos of alpha 1. Okay, so this is what the formula. Okay, now see here, put the value of this PC1 here. So from this equation what we got here, D1 is equal to what? PN divided by cos of alpha 1 divided into T1 divided by pi. So this is what the divide. Now next thing is that we are going to see the D2. So the P circle diameter of gear 2. So D2 is equal to what? Again here PC2 into pi to PC2 into T2 divided by pi. This is what the D2. So already we know that PC2, circular pitch of gear 2, is equal to what? Pi into D2 divided by T2. This formula will be there. Okay, so by using this formula we can find out here, from this formula we find out here D2. So D2 is nothing but what? PC2 into T2 divided by pi. Okay, now see here, this formula will be here. Okay, now next thing is that we know that instead of PC2 we can write down here PN divided by, PC is equal to what? PN divided by cos of phi. Okay, so here is what? PC2, therefore PN divided by cos of alpha 2. Okay, so this is what we can put here. Instead of this PC2 we can write down here PN divided by cos of alpha 2 into this T2 divided by pi. Okay, so see here, therefore D2 is equal to what? T2 divided by T1. And now here is what we can take here, we have the value of D1 and we have the value of D2. Therefore D1 divided by D2 is equal to PN, PN will get cancelled here. In previous one what we got the value, that is what the here PN divided by cos of alpha 2 into T1. Okay, so what is the value? So from this PN, PN will get cancelled here. What remains here? T2 divided by T1, T2 divided by T1, cos alpha 1 divided by cos alpha 2. Pi, pi will get cancelled here. Okay, so from this equation, D2 and D1, we got here D2 by D1 is equal to what? T2 cos of alpha 1 divided by T1 into cos of alpha 2. Okay, so this is what a D2 by D1. Next is what we know, that this is what equation number 2. So this D2 by D1, this is what equation number 2. So we know that N2 by N1 is equal to what? T1 by T2. We know that N2 by N1 is equal to what? T1 by T2 is nothing but what? A gear ratio G. Okay, so see here, T1 by T2 is equal to what? N2 by N1. This is what equation number 3. Now see here, multiplying equation 2 and 3 we get. That means we are going to multiply equation number 2 and 3. Okay, this is what equation number 2 and this is what equation number 3. Okay, we are going to multiply equation number 2 and 3. So what we got here? D2 N2 divided by D1 N1 is equal to what? Cos of alpha 1 divided by cos of alpha 2. So what get cancelled here? Here is what? What cancelled? D2 by T1 will be cancelled here. So what we got here? Alpha 1. So what we got here? Alpha 1 divided by alpha. for 2. This is what d2 into n2 divided by d1 into n1. Okay, so substituting the value in equation 1, we are going to put this value d2 n2 divided by d1 n1 into equation number 1. So what we got value, so this is what efficiency is equal to what, cos of alpha 2 plus phi into cos of alpha 1 divided by cos of alpha 1 minus phi into cos of alpha 2. So this is what the value, this is if we substitute the value in equation number 1, so we got here, this is what efficiency, this efficiency is equal to what, cos of alpha 2 plus phi into cos of alpha 1 divided by cos of alpha 1 minus phi into cos of alpha 2. So the here, see here, this is what formula, cos A cos B. So this term will be angle here, cos angle will be there, okay. So these terms will be different, okay. So this is what cos alpha cos beta, cos alpha cos beta. So we have the formula of cos alpha cos beta. So this is what formula put here by using this formula. So see here, put here this cos alpha 1, this is what A, okay, and this alpha 2 plus phi, this is what B, okay. Similarly, so this alpha 2 will be A, and this cos alpha 1 minus beta, this is what B. So we know that the formula cos A into cos B is equal to cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Again, similarly, cos A into B, the cos A into cos B is equal to cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Okay, so by using this formula, we got here cos of alpha 1 plus alpha 2 plus phi plus cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2 minus phi divided by cos of alpha 2 plus alpha 1 minus phi plus cos of alpha 2 minus alpha 1 plus phi. So this is what the cos A cos B is equal to half of cos A plus B plus cos of A minus B. This is what the formula. So that is by using this formula, we got this term. Now see here, what will the common terms? So common terms will be the, we know that this alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is nothing but what, in earlier we seen that, we already seen that alpha 1 plus alpha 2 in terms we written that theta is equal to what, alpha 1 plus alpha 2. Instead of this alpha 1 plus alpha 2, we can write here theta, okay. Instead of this one, we can write here theta. So what we got here, this theta plus phi. So cos of this theta plus phi, this theta is nothing but what, alpha 1 plus alpha 2. Similarly here, this cos of alpha 1 plus alpha 2, that is alpha 2 plus alpha 1, this is more theta minus this phi, okay, plus cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2 minus phi. So alpha 1 minus alpha 2 minus phi, again cos of alpha 2 minus alpha 1 in plus phi, this term will be as it is, okay. So see here, this is what we can write here, equation number 4, okay. Now see here, since the angle theta and phi are constant, these are the constant angles, that is what theta and phi, these are the constant angles, therefore the efficiency will be the maximum when these are the constant, that means the efficiency will be the maximum when cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2 minus phi is maximum, okay. The efficiency, when will be the become the efficiency will be maximum, see here. Suppose the efficiency will be maximum, when it will be maximum, so this cos of alpha 1 alpha minus alpha 2 minus phi is equal to maximum, okay. So this will be the maximum, that is we can write here cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2 minus phi is equal to 1, or cos 1, when become cos 1, if cos 0 is equal to what, 1. So simply these terms, this alpha 1 minus alpha 2 minus phi becomes 0. This cos of 0 is equal to, we know that cos of 0 is equal to what, 1, okay. So we, for that one, for this term becomes 0, okay. So therefore alpha 1 is equal to what, from this equation alpha 1 is equal to what, alpha 2 plus phi, okay, and alpha 2 is equal to what, alpha 1 minus phi, okay. So we got here what value of alpha 1 and alpha 2 in terms of phi, okay. Since alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is equal to theta, therefore we know that alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is equal to theta, therefore alpha 1 is equal to theta minus alpha 2 is equal to theta minus alpha 1 plus phi. So see here, what written here, this theta is equal to what? We know that. So theta is equal to what? Alpha 1 plus alpha 2. Okay, so simply we can write down alpha 1 is equal, nothing but what? Theta minus alpha 2. We have the value of alpha 2, that is what? Theta minus alpha 1 plus phi. Okay, therefore alpha 1 is equal to, this alpha 1 is equal to what? Theta plus phi divided by 2. Okay, so similarly we are going to see the alpha 1 or alpha 2. Alpha 2 is equal to what? Theta minus phi divided by 2. Only similar sign will, the plus and minus sign will be different. Here alpha 1 is equal to what? Theta plus phi divided by 2, and alpha 2 is equal to what? Theta minus phi divided by 2. Okay, so see here, substituting value of this alpha 1 is equal to what? Alpha 2 plus phi. Again alpha 2 is equal to what? Alpha 1 minus phi. In equation 5 we get, if you are going to put the value in equation number 5, we get here, okay, this maximum efficiency and max is equal to what? Cos of theta plus phi plus 1, or divided by cos of theta minus phi plus 1. So this is what, this is nothing but maximum efficiency. A maximum efficiency is equal to, this is nothing but what? Ratio of cos of theta plus phi plus 1 divided by cos of theta minus phi plus 1. So this is what the maximum efficiency. Note from the figure, we can find out this is normal reaction. Rn is equal to what? F1 divided by cos of alpha 1 is equal to F2 divided by cos of alpha 2. Therefore, the axial thrust on the driver FA1, we are going to see these terms, that is Rn is equal to what? And on the driver side, this is what? F1 divided by cos of alpha 1. On driven side, this is what? F2 divided by cos of alpha 2. Again, the axial thrust force, that is FA1, this FA1 is nothing but what? Rn into sine of alpha 1 is equal to what? F1 into tan of alpha 1. These both terms are correct, okay? And axial thrust on the driven, that is FA2, is equal to what? Rn sine of alpha 2 is equal to F2 tan of alpha 2, okay? So this is nothing but what? The efficiency of the spiral gear, okay? On next lecture, we are going to see the numericals based on the spiral gear, okay? We will stop here. Thank you.